Hi kids, this is teacher Vidya. Let's learn about the resources. Resources are things people use and need. Resources give us shelter, water, light and food. Resources need to be conserved for future generations to enjoy. But we also need to use them now to live comfortably. Countries also need to use resources for their development. A natural resource is something that comes from nature and which people can use. We cannot make natural resources. We can only gather them from nature. Some natural resources are sunlight, air, water, trees, wind, metals, and fossil fuels. All these resources are not found everywhere. The distribution of natural resources depends on a number of physical factors like landforms, climate, and altitude. For example, important metals like iron ore, manganese, and bauxite are often found in plateaus like the Deccan Plateau of India and the Plateau of South Africa. Tropical evergreen forests are found in areas of heavy rainfall such as the Western Ghats and the Amazon Basin. Fertile soil is found in the river basins of Ganga and the river Nile. To convert these gifts of nature into useful resources, man adds value and utility to them. Some resources like petroleum, derived from fossil fuel, have great commercial value. Precious metals like gold have economic value. Man, in his search for development, discovers new resources or invents new ways to use these resources. Before sharing his inventions with the world, man needs to patent them first so that no other person can claim his ideas. Let us understand how man develops useful resources. Fossil fuels have been used since cavemen discovered how to burn peat or coal for heat. Alexander the Great burnt petroleum to scare the war elephants of his enemies. In 1859, an American named Edwin L. Drake began the modern-day petroleum industry in the USA when he drilled a 69-foot-deep well and discovered crude oil. This was an important discovery because at that time there was a shortage of whale oil that was being used to light up homes and grease machines in some industries. The crude oil was obtained from this well was immediately put to use. Today, this crude oil, refined as petroleum, touches every moment of our lives. We depend on petroleum for cars, airplanes, and even our eyes glass frames or lenses may be of plastic made from petroleum. The resource here is crude oil, which is a fossil fuel. Man has invented a way of extracting this crude oil not only from oil wells on land but also from the seabed with the help of oil rigs. Similarly, man has found a way of generating electricity from coal, natural gas, and fast flowing water. Classification of resources. There are different ways to classify natural resources based on the following criteria: sources of origin, stage of development, on the basis of exhaustibility, on the basis of distribution. Source of origin. Biotic resources. These resources are obtained from living materials such as plants and animals. Abiotic resources. These resources are obtained from non-living and non-organic material. These include resources like land, water, air, and metals like gold, iron, copper, and silver. Stage of development. Potential resources. These are resources that are not being used on a large scale at present in some parts of the world, but may be used in the future. Wind energy is a potential energy resource in India. Actual resources. These are resources whose quantity and quality are known to man and that are being used at present. Example: coal deposits of Damodar Valley, coal field in India are actual resources. However, the use of these resources is dependent on technology, which may vary from one region to the another region. Reserve. This is a part of the actual reserve that is not being used at present, but if the need arises, it can be used in the future. Example: the reserve of natural gas in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands of India is such a resource. Stock resources. These are resources that have been identified but cannot be used due to a lack of technology. Example: biofuel that can be derived from crushed sugarcane or bagasse is such a resource. On the basis of exhaustibility, renewable resources. These are resources that can be used repeatedly, like water, sunlight, and wind. Non-renewable resources. These are resources that form very slowly. A resource is considered to be non-renewable when it is exhausted at a rate faster than it was made. Example: fossil fuels, which have taken more than a million years to form. On the basis of distribution, ubiquitous resources. These resources are found everywhere, like the air we breathe are ubiquitous. Localized. These resources like metals, minerals, and precious stones found only in places are called localized resources. Example: crude oil is found in some parts of the world, like the Arabian Peninsula and the Assam of India. It takes people time and technology to convert materials obtained from nature into useful resources. Therefore, humans are the most important resource. Our knowledge and ideas have helped us to discover new ways of using natural resources efficiently with the help of technology. In today's world, technology is developing at a very fast rate. Each invention encourages many others. The invention of wheel changed the life of humans in many ways. It is used to carry people and goods from one place to another in the potter's wheel, cycles, tiny watch gears, and in cars and aeroplanes. Water wheel is an innovation that is changing the lives of women in rural India. We learn to extract minerals and metals like gold, copper, iron ore, and limestone and convert them into important resources. We then used these resources to make equipment, vehicles, machines, and buildings with the help of technology. In search for new sources of energy, humans have invented technology to tap alternate resources. These resources are renewable, widely available, and environment friendly. They cause little or almost no pollution. Humans invented the windmill to tap wind power, solar panels to tap the energy from sunlight, and machines to extract biofuel from waste wood, crushed sugarcane, and agricultural waste. Educated and skilled people help in the rapid development of the country. Certain countries which have large uneducated population thus lag behind in development. Knowledge, ideas, skills, thought. Let us learn how man has modified resources. The need of the hour is not only to conserve resources, but also to discover ways to generate alternate resources. This will ensure that people living in all countries across the world have resources for a good quality of life. Conservation of resources thus means the careful and planned use as well as reuse of natural resources by avoiding wastage, misuse, and overuse. Sustainable development means development through careful extraction of resources to meet the requirement of the present without compromising on the need of the future. This will only be possible by protecting our environment and avoiding wastage. Sustainable development will not only help in the development of a country, but will also ensure that people have sufficient resources for a good standard of living. Let's learn about the principles of sustainable development. Respect and care for all forms of life. Improve the quality of human life. Conserve resources and protect the environment. Minimize the depletion of natural resources. Change personal attitudes and practice towards the environment. Enable communities to take care for their own environment. People need to take steps to ensure that activities linked to development, such as cutting down of trees and extracting metals and minerals, do not lead to irreversible damage to the environment. The practice of the three R's, reduce, reuse, and recycle, must become the practice for a healthy environment. Thank you so much, kids.